So cardiac cycle is the activities in which the heart of the chambers of the heart, there are four chambers in the human heart, two auricles and two ventricles, or you can say two atria and two ventricles. So the chambers of the heart undergo alternate contraction. Contraction in biological term is termed as systole, and it then after contraction it undergoes relaxation, also called as distension, and in medical term it is called as diastole. So the four chambers of the heart undergo alternate contraction followed by relaxation, and this cyclic sequence of the event of contraction and relaxation is called as the cardiac cycle. It has three phases, so even we will be reading it from the NCRT also. So it has three phases. Now those three phases are basically called as the atrial systole, which lasts for 0.1 second. So after atrial contraction or systole, then the next event to occur is the ventricular systole. And once the ventricles undergo relaxation for contraction for 0.3 second, later it is the relaxation of both these type of chambers, which is called as the joint diastole. Diastole stands for relaxation or distension, and systole stands for the contraction. So the total amount comes out to be 0.1, 0.3 and 0.4, it comes out to be 0.8 second. So a cardiac cycle requires 0.8 second to be covered. And let's start with the topic. So it starts first of all with the simultaneous filling of the atria as well as the ventricle. So we need to understand a concept that when the cardiac cycle start, all the four chambers of the heart, that means atria and ventricles, they all are in relaxed situation. Because they are in relaxed situation, blood continues to come into atria, and from atria it continues to go into ventricle. Therefore, there is a simultaneous filling of both atria and ventricle, and nearly 70% of total blood enters into ventricle in this manner. So nearly 70% of the blood enters from ventricle passively, and then both atria get filled with the blood. An SA node gets stimulated and produces the myogenic impulse. Now you can relate this concept with the heartbeat. Because the blood is entering into the atria and atria is passing the blood into the ventricle. So finally what happened during the simultaneous filling of both the chambers, that 70% of the blood has already reached the ventricle. Now what happened next is, because the amount of blood left in the atria is too less to move, so there comes the concept of low pressure. So the pressure is generated because of the contraction of both atria simultaneously. So this happens because the pacemaker will start working. So SA node generates the impulse. This impulse causes both of the atria to undergo contraction simultaneously, and this contraction occurs in 0.1 second. So the next thing to understand is the atrial systole. So we begin with the relaxed situation in which both four chambers are getting filled, and finally whatever blood is left in the atria, it undergoes it passes into the ventricle because of the contraction of both atria. This happens because of SA node's stimulation takes place. So 30% of the blood, that means we have already covered 70%, 30% of the blood is pushed into the respective ventricles through the atrioventricular aperture, and this happens because SA node has caused an impulse to be generated which causes both left and right atria to undergo contraction for 0.1 second. After this, what happened? To prevent the backflow, now we all know if the atria are undergoing contraction, the blood may try to escape from the atria because the volume is decreasing. Now the blood should enter into ventricles through the AV apertures. That means the tricuspid, bicuspid valve should open and they should allow the blood to go into ventricle. But there are chances the blood may enter back into the veins from where it has come into the atria. So to prevent this backflow into the veins, there are some adaptive features. So the first feature is resistance from the blood in the veins. Veins already carry blood inside, so that will bring a resistance against the backflowing blood. And second point, there are sphincters over the roots of the veins, and these sphincters are closed. Because of this, blood fails to enter back into the veins and it will successfully go into the ventricles. So after systole, atria begins to undergo relaxation for 0.7 seconds. Remember that the cardiac cycle lasts for 0.8 seconds. So if the atria are contracting for 0.1 second, then definitely for the next 0.7 second, both atria are going to undergo relaxation. Now what is the next step? The next step is the ventricular filling. So the ventricles have already filled because 70% of the blood passively entered the air and 30% went in because of the activity of the SA node. So it happens actively. After this filling of the ventricle, the next step is the ventricular systole. Now, once the ventricles are fully filled with blood, they are going to contract for 0.3 seconds. So the impulse generated by SA node by this time has already reached the AV node. And AV node will cause this message to pass through the bundle of His, finally reaching the Purkinje fiber. This causes both ventricles to undergo contraction simultaneously, and as they contract, the blood is going to leave the respective ventricles and enter into the respective aorta. That means the right ventricle will pass on the blood into the pulmonary artery and the left ventricle will pass on the blood into the systemic aorta.